There are 350 nationally registered historic places in the city of Chicago. Now 120 of those, like the one behind me, the Field Museum, are located in the central city. And I thought to myself, is it possible for someone to visit 120 of those locations in one day? So I thought I'd give it a go. Quinn Chapel, the Vesta Building, 1913, Harriet F. Reese's house. This was actually located further south, but because of the new development at McCormick Place, they moved it one block north. It cost $6 million to move the house, and an additional $1.2 million just for the property. Lakeside Technology Center, or Cormet Center, Willicon House, built in 1870. The Reed House, right next to Harriet Reese's house. And if you notice the change in the daylight, that's because I didn't figure that out. William Kimball House is now the headquarters of the US Soccer Federation. This is just the back of the John S. Glessner House. It's absolutely massive. This is the Prairie Avenue Historical District. They have a ton of historic houses here. They even have a museum where you can go for free public tours. Second Presbyterian Church, B.F. Goodrich Motor Showroom. It's built in 1911 and part of Motor Row. The Curtis Wright Aeronautical University Building, Hillard Towers, or Hillard Historic District. The Maxwell Briscoe Showroom, St. Luke's Hospital, Coca-Cola Company Building. Built in 1904, it was their first headquarters outside Atlanta. And of course, we have the beautiful Grant Park Field Museum. It used to be located in Jackson Park, they moved it up here in about 1920. The Adler Planetarium, built in 1930. The Shedd Aquarium, it holds 5 million gallons of water. The Somerset Hotel. The Ludington Building, built in 1892. The Fairbank Morse & Company Building. The YMCA Hotel. Crane Company Building. Blackstone Hotel. Lakeside Press Building. Dearborn Station. The Pontiac Building, which is actually in the nationally registered district of Printer Row in Chicago.
We've got a 3-on-1. We've got the Chicago Club at the very end, the Studebaker Building in the middle, and at the other side, we've got the auditorium for Roosevelt University.
Buckingham Building. The Rothschild & Company Store. This is the second Lyrta Building. I absolutely just butchered that name. We've got the Old Colony Building and the Fisher Building across the street. The old Fort Dearborn Hotel, built in 1914. The Chicago Board of Trade and the Rookery Building. The Chicago Federal Center. The Nadoff Block. The Printing Row House District. We've got the Railway Exchange and the Orchestral Hall. The Chapin and Gore Building. The McClurg Building. The Singer Building. The Marquette Building. The Inland Steel Building. One North LaSalle Building. The Lumber Exchange Building. The Conway Building.
The big building on the right there is the People's Gas Building. And the little building wedged in the middle, that's the Municipal Court Building.
The Reliance Building. Marshall Fields Company Store. Cargo Savings Bank Building, built in 1905. The Carson Peary Scott & Company Building. The Jewelers Building. Over here we have the Silversmith Hotel. And we're actually in the historic Lube retail area. The Gage Group Buildings, Chicago's old public library, now the Chicago Cultural Center, the New Masonic Center and Oriental Theater, the Oliver Typewriting Company Building, and the Delaware Building. Praise Brothers Building and the Chicago Theater, which opened in 1921. Randolph Tower opened in 1929. This is the Trustee System Services Building, the Reed Murdoch Building, the IBM Building. Currently in the Michigan Wacker Historic District. It's about 3:30 in the afternoon. We've got a little bit left to go, but we're north of the river. Jean Baptiste home site, the Cook County Criminal Court Building, Chicago Varnish Company Building, the Boyce Building, the Tree Studio Building and Annex, the old Chicago Historical Building, built in 1892 and it's said to be haunted. Nickerson House, Navy Pier, and the Chicago Lighthouse. 860 to 880 Lakeshore Drive, those two buildings. This isn't good. I'm running out of light. I've still got a bunch of buildings to go to. 257 East Delaware. The Newville. Brian Lathlop House. Drake Hotel. And behind it, the Palm Olive Building. Fourth Presbyterian Church. Chicago Avenue Water Pump and Water Tower. The only building under scaffolding, Hotel St. Benedict's. Quigley Preparatory Seminary. The American Four Building.
And one of the buildings on Pearson has been demolished.
The Bush Temple of Music. William Waller's House. And we're right next to Washington Square Historical District. Washington Square. The Burlingham Building. Isaac Maynard's Row Houses. In the Gold Coast Historical District, James Chalney House, Albert Madler House, Wooden Alley, the Germania Club, West Burton Place Historical District. Behind that tree is the Emil Building. We're currently in North Wells Historic District, the Swedish Club of Chicago, the Marshall Fields Garden Apartments. And unfortunately, there's no light left, so we're gonna have to call it there. There's two places which I didn't manage to visit. If you can guess what they are, you're doing pretty well.
I'm a little upset that I didn't make it to the last two locations. You know, I kind of failed the challenge, but the real goal was for me to discover more about Chicago and be familiar with the city that I'm just living in now. So if you like this video, give it a like, Maybe subscribe for more Chicago videos that are coming up.
An honorable mention goes to Soldier Field, whose renovations in 2002 to 2003 actually got it delisted from the National Register of Historic Places.